How you doing today, folks? This morning from Moodyville. Can you hear the birds and the geese? Well, anyway, this evening, I'm gonna be the honorary chair of the fundraiser for a organization that helps women, survivors of childhood sexual abuse, and now they're going to expand to men. And, you know, even though I enjoy speaking, it's sad to think we even have to have organizations like this. But I'm very happy that we do because it's helping so many people. But the good news is next year, February 2023, I am going to hike Mt. Kilimanjaro. And I'm going to do that to hopefully inspire others who deal with anxiety, panic attacks. In 2017, I did 8 days down the Grand Canyon, rafting, and didn't sleep with a tent, just slept with a cot. And then I hiked out 7.5 miles, 4,200 feet. Now, elevation change. Now I'm gonna go to Mt. Kilimanjaro and push myself physically, but also mentally. And I think back, you know, how much of my life, you know, I'm 65 now, I'll be 66 in May. But I think back how much anxiety and panic attacks really affected my life from that trauma of childhood sexual abuse. I wish I could have done Kilimanjaro, many things like that much earlier in my life, but anxiety just ruled me. And, you know, anxiety, panic attacks, childhood sexual abuse, any kind of trauma, it affects all ages, religion, races, you name it. It doesn't discriminate, folks. And let's keep being aware. Let's keep helping each other. Let's be, you know, support your local childhood advocacy centers. Let's not be afraid to deal with mental health, panic attacks, and anxiety and PTSD. It's a mental health issue. But I share my story and speak up because I don't want anyone else to suffer in silence. I did in 1992. When I finally addressed and finally said for the first time in my life, I had been sexually abused as a child. I started having really bad panic attacks, had a complete breakdown, and I suffered in silence because I was ashamed, thought I was weak, and didn't want anyone to know what was happening. So folks, the good news is we can get through this. Also, this is very important. I'm 1 week now after 30 years of taking a pill for anxiety, and it's an antidepressant, but I never suffered with depression, but you use those pills for anxiety. And because I took cognitive behavioral therapy, I'm much stronger, much better, because I finally went to the root of my problem as far as how that trauma really impacted me. Now, I'm not a therapist or anything, so I'm not telling anybody come off their meds. No. You come off your meds with your therapist's help when the time is right. I decided I was ready to no longer do it, and I feel great. But I also realize how carbs and sugar were my comfort. Some people turn to alcohol, drugs, or different things. Mine was carbs and sugar. I work out constantly, and I'm in good physical shape, but my weight has always been higher over since 92. Once I start having anxiety and panic attacks, carbs and sugar became my comfort. So I want y'all to pray for me as I get ready for Mt. Kilimanjaro. I'm going to lose 40 pounds. I'm going to get in the best shape ever. Even though I'm in good shape for my age, I'm going to go to another level. And also, I'm going to just watch carbs and sugar. And I'm thrilled to be an honorary host tonight for this great organization. And folks, don't ever give up. Keep going. And as we always say in Moodyville, peace.